Hello dear students, myself Dr. Sachin Gurule, assistant professor from Department of Zoology, KTHM College, Nasik. In the previous video of subject Animal Diversity 3rd for SYBSC, we are learning the chapter number 4, that is Introduction to Superclass Pisces. And in this chapter, we have learned till now the silent features of superclass Pisces. Then we have learned the classification and we have seen the two classes, that is Chondrichthyes and Ostrichthyes, belongs to that superclass Pisces. Now in this lecture we are going to learn the types of scales found into the fishes. So let's see the types of scales in the fishes. Now, body of all the vertebrate organism has an exoskeletal covering on the body, and it is often made up of either epidermal scale or the dermal scales. The epidermal scales, they are present in many terrestrial vertebrates such as the reptiles, birds and the mammals. So here in this diagram you can see the scales are of two type or two origin. Either they are from the epidermal origin or either they are from the dermal origin. So whatever scales which are present into the fishes, these are the dermal in origin, means they are originate from the dermis. While in other vertebrates, for example the reptiles, birds and mammals, the scales are originated from the epidermis, and hence they are epidermal in origin. So the different kinds of the scales we can recognize into the terrestrial vertebrate. For example, in this diagram you can see the scales which are present on the reptiles. There are different kinds of the scales present on the different region of the body in the reptiles, for example lizards. Then the legs of the reptiles, they are often provided with a specialized modified scales which are known as scutes. So here in this diagram you can see the scutes which are also the epidermal scales. Then the shield which are present on the dorsal side of the head, particularly in case of the snakes, which is also the epidermal in origin, and again that snakes are belongs to the reptilia, that is they are well known reptiles. And the scales are also present on the birds. So here if you see, these are the legs of the chicken which are provided with a scales, and all these scales are of the epidermal in origin. Means the scales which are present into the vertebrate organism is either dermal in origin or epidermal in origin. In case of fishes, these are dermal in origin, while in rest of the vertebrate, that is reptiles, birds and mammals, these scales are the epidermal in origin. Now dermal scales, they are originate from the mesenchyme and they are well developed among the fishes. So these dermal scales which are present into the fishes, these are originating from the mesenchyme area, and the dermal scales which are found into the fishes, these are small, thin, cornified, calcareous or a bony plate that fits compactly and overlaps each other. So here in this diagram you can see the scales are somewhat small, thin, and these scales are compactly arranged on the skin, and generally they are overlapping some part of the scale with the neighboring scale or the adjacent scale. So this is usual, the arrangement of the scales you will found among the fishes. The scales vary in size, it also varies in a shape in different species, but often consist of the three layers, and these three layers present into the scales in case of fishes is the innermost layer, which is known as the isoprene. So here this one is a innermost layer which is known as the isoprene, and usually it contains a pulp cavity. Then second one is the intermediate spongy layer. So this is intermediate the spongy layer, and the outermost layer is referred as the dentine. So in this way, the scales in case of fishes is always composed of the three layers. Innermost known as the isoprene, intermediate is known as a spongy layer, and the outermost known as the dentine layer. So among the fishes, there are five types of dermal scales are found, and these scales are known as the placoid scale. So here you can see the placoid scale. Then next one is a ganoid scale, then the ctenoid scale, then the cycloid scale, and the cosmoid scales. So these are the five categories of the dermal scales which are found into the fishes belongs to the various group that we are going to learn one by one. First of all, start with the cycloid scale. Now the cycloid scales are found into the lower telost. The lower telost includes the labio. So here in this diagram you can see the labio. It also contains a cathla and the cord. So the labio, cathla and the cord, these are lower telost fishes containing a cycloid scale. Now cycloid scale you will also found into the dipnoi and holostei fishes. For example, the amia. In case of amia also, you can able to found the cycloid kind of the scale, and it is also found into the dipnoi fishes such as the lungs fishes. So cycloid scale is present into the telost, dipnoi and holostei, and these scales forms a protective outer covering over the skin. So whatever skin is there in this kind of the fishes, all they are covered with the help of these cycloid or somewhat oval scales. Now these scales are thin, flexible, translucent, dermal plates and roughly circular or rounded in shape. So here in this diagram you can see the shape of the scale is somewhat oval, and hence accordingly they are referred as the cycloid scale. Now these are thicker in the center. So if you see the center position, that center, at the center it is thicker, and as you go towards the marginal region, these becomes a thinner one. So central portion is a thicker one and the marginal portion is the thinner one for that cycloid scale. Now they are located in the dermal pockets and possesses the concentric lines of growth. So here in this diagram you can see the lines of growth can be easily recognized, and these lines of growth hence present into the fishes known fishes is also referred as the cycloid scales because the presence of these lines of growth. Now lines of growth are used to determine the age of the fishes. Usually the number of lines of growth, they are added as fish becomes older and older. So accordingly to how many numbers of the lines of growth present into the scales, the age of that fish can be determined. Their free borders, these are the free borders, and these free borders are more or less rounded and remains exposed one, while the posterior part has a numerous longitudinal grooves. So this is a posterior region which are provided with a numerous longitudinal grooves, and these grooves are present for getting the nourishment from the skin, as this portion is get connected with that of the dermis, and from that grooves they obtain the nourishment. Okay, so this is belongs to the posterior part. So this is a posterior part and this one is a anterior part, and here you can see some longitudinal grooves are there, and these longitudinal grooves getting or receiving the nourishment from that of the skin. Then cycloid scales, they are composed of the thin upper layer of the bone, lower layer of the fibrous connective tissue, but here pulp cavity is absent, means there is no pulp cavity into the cycloid scales. Now these scales are soft, arranged lengthwise in a diagonal rows, and these scales that derive from the ganoid scale in which the ganoid, cosmoid and bone cells are lost. Means actually the cycloid scales, they are get modified or they are derived from the ganoid kind of the scale, that ganoid scale which is found into the ancient fishes actually. And in these scales, when the ganoid, cosmoid and the bone cells are lost, they are going to form the another separate type of scale which are now known as the cycloid scales. Now scale covering the lateral line are frequently perforated, permitting the passage of the small connective of the lateral line to the outside. And we have already discussed that lateral lines, these are important receptors or the sense organ present into the fishes. So and this is about the cycloid scale, which is the characteristic feature of the lower telost, dipnoid and holosty fishes. Then the second one is a tenoid scale. Now these tenoid scales, they are found into the higher telost. Now which are the highest telost? Telost like a perch, sunfish, which are referred as the highest telost fishes. So in case of perch and sunfish, they are containing the tenoid kind of the scales in their skin. Now this sunfish is a very huge and very heavy fish, and they are so called as because of their habit of sun basking. So they frequently comes at the surface to get a appropriate amount of the sunlight, and hence they are also referred as a sunfish. In addition to these fishes, the another fishes such as the actinopterygian fishes, they also contain such a kind of the scales which are referred as the tenoid scale. Now these tenoid scales are thin, they are soft and dermal, translucent dermal plates. Its grooves like part is firmly attached to the dermis, while its hind teeth bearing part, it remains free. So these are the teeth which are present. These teeth are always free. Now these scales are embedded in a small dermal pockets, and the concentric lines of growth with the teeth like projection are the characteristics, and at the posterior side, hence they are named as the tenoid scale. Now that word tenoid is derived from the characteristic feature, that is the teeth or the spine like structure present at the one end of these scales. Hence these are referred as the tenoid scales. Now many longitudinal grooves are present on the posterior attached end, which is used to getting a nourishment from that of the skin. So obviously whenever longitudinal grooves are there, that longitudinal grooves are from the posterior side, they are generally attached to the skin for getting the nourishment to the that scale. The pulp cavity, dentine layer are completely absent. So here in this tenoid scale also, there is no pulp cavity, there is no dentine layer, and these scales are arranged obliquely. So the posterior end of one scale overlaps the anterior part of the next. So in this way, these tenoid scales are also arranged in the overlapping one to the another, and they are arranged very compactly on the skin of the higher telost fishes and the actinopterygian fishes. Now these scales are derived from again the ganoid kind of the scale in which the ganoid, cosmoid and bone cells are lost. Means both these cycloid and the tenoid scales, which are derived from the ganoid scale by the losing the ganoid part, cosmoid part and the bone cell. So this is about the second type of scale, that is the tenoid scale. The next one is a placoid scale. Now placoid scales are also called as a dermal denticles, And these dermal denticles, so called as a placoid scale, are the characteristic feature of the elasmobranch fishes. Elasmobranch fishes are also known as the chondrichthyes. For example, the placoid scales are found into the shark, that is Coleodon, then hammerheaded shark, Spirina, and the fishes like a torpedo. So this is the characteristic feature of the elasmobranch fishes or the chondrichthyes fishes. Now these placoid scales are arranged in regular oblique rows covering the entire surface of the body. So these scales are highly concentrated at the dorsal side, particularly from that of the ventral side. So more scales are present at the dorsal side, and obviously in some cases the ventral side there is no scales. The placoid scales are small, pointed, and they are triradiated denticles. So here, if you see the diagram of the scale, this is a triradiating or the spine-like structure which contains a three spines. Hence, it is referred as the trident spine. And they also composed of a basal bony plate. This basal bony plate is also referred as a basal rhomboidal plate because it is of having a rhomboidal shape, and this plate is embedded into the dermis. Now from this plate, the spine projects upward and points posteriorly. So this is a unique feature which is found among the this chondrichthyes fishes or the elasmobranch fishes, that is, the scales are backwardly directed. Now this basal plate is formed of a trabecular calcified tissue, and it is embedded into the dermis, which held by the Sharpless fiber and the other connective tissue. This Sharpless fiber and the connective tissue is responsible for holding this basal rhomboidal plate into the dermis region, and from that plate the trident spine, which projects out and is directed in backward condition. The spine is composed of the dentine, which is covered by a hard material, and this hard material is referred as the vitrodentine. So the outermost layer of the spine, which is referred as or is made up of the hard material, is referred as the vitrodentine. Now it is partly dermal and partly epidermal in origin. The placoid scale comprises a pulp cavity. So here you can see this is a pulp cavity. The pulp cavity is present into the placoid scale. We have learned in the cycloid scale and the ctenoid scale that pulp cavity is absent. So, but here the pulp cavity is present. Then, this pulp cavity contains the odontoblast, then dentine forming cells, blood capillaries, nerves, and the lymph canals. So this is about the placoid scale, which consists of the trident spine and the basal plate. This scale is partly epidermal and partly dermal in origin. So this is a characteristic feature for the placoid scale. And the last kind of the scale is a ganoid scale. Now this ganoid scale is also referred as the rhomboidal scale. And this rhomboidal scale or the ganoid scale, they are found into the primitive actinopterygian fishes, for example, Polypterus. Now, this Polypterus is also referred as a walking fish. So, these fishes are usually present at the bottom of the water bodies. So, example is the Polypterus. Then, another example is Accipenser. This Accipenser, and third example is the Lepidosteus. So these are belongs to the actinopterygii, which are the primitive fishes, and all these primitive fishes contains a scale which is known as the ganoid scale, or it is also referred as the rhomboidal scale. Now ganoid scales are compactly fitted on the body wall side by side like that of the tiles. So if you see the overall shape of the scale is somewhat a rhomboidal one, and it looking like a tiles, and these are highly closely fitted with one another on the body wall, and hence in the first impression they are giving the appearance of that of the tiles which are present into the scale. These scales are heavy and have a outer layer of hard inorganic enamel like material, and this enamel like material is referred as the ganoin. And as the presence of the ganoin in this scale, they are referred as the ganoid scale. Their middle layer is a cosmoid and it contains a numerous branching tubules. The innermost layer is the thickest one and is made up of a lamellar bone which is known as the isoepidine. So this isoepidine is present at the center in the lamellar bone. The scales are usually rhomboidal in shape and articulated by a peg or the socket joint, and these scales are dermal in origin. So these scales are dermal in origin, and the characteristic feature of the primitive fishes belongs to the actinopterygii. So in this way, the different kinds of the scales we can recognize on the skin of the fishes, and this is about the types of fishes present into the different species. So here again in this diagram you can see the rhomboidal or the ganoid kind of the scale which are provided with a peg like structure from which they are joined with that of the skin as the socket joint. So this is about the types of scales in the fishes. Thank you very much.